have a constitutional right to have land. And there is no any place where we can go apart from Matongo. So it is an appeal for us as a community of Matongo government to give us our land.
According to the chairperson for Matongo Lost Land Recovery Families Organization, they were evicted in 1920 due to the outbreak of sleeping sickness in the area.
In 1920, there was an outbreak of sleeping sickness that invaded this area, which forced the government, by then the British government, to advise people to leave the place as a protection of their life. But unfortunately, by evicting them, they were not resettled or anywhere. Those without friends went to Congo and other parts of the country.
He further noted that they went back to their land. However, Obote II's government again evicted them from the same land.
To their land, and enjoyed their land from 1992 to 1983. Then when Obote II came back, he re-evicted them, and unconditionally, without giving a reason, at least for the first time, it was because of sleeping sickness.
After the demonstration, their leaders carrying posters went to deliver a letter for the security to allow them to go back to their land tomorrow. But Wumaru Muhanguzi, the deputy RDC for Wundi Wujo district, advised them to hold on as government will soon respond to their outcry.
Still this information, we are going to forward it to the relevant authorities and then we wait. My only humble prayer is that things remain peaceful. Because now we cannot fight for this land for the last 20 and so years. And then you say you want to die. Now if you die, you will die.
The LC5 chairperson for Wundi Wujo district reiterated their commitment to solve the problem at hand.
I want to inform you that I'm aware of this problem. And because I'm aware of it, I want to also inform you that when I was making my issues, when I was capturing my issues to address in the manifesto, I put this one as number 3. So I'm aware of it. I want to assure everybody who is here that my office is committed to ensuring that this problem is handled.
The evictees called upon the president and other relevant authority to intervene into the matter.
The president, please come for our rescue. You are the fountain of honor. You are citizen number one, and these are your voters. How can we suffer in the hands of a parent? You are our parent. Nowhere we can go. So
Tiba Kunira further noted that the district does not have land to accommodate these evictees currently.
Land that can actually accommodate this people. As a district, we are also curtailed. We have a challenge of land. The only available piece of land now is that one which was donated to the district local government by World Harvest Mission, and they were using it as an airstrip. It is very small. It can only accommodate like 2 households, if not 1. So these are very many people.
Report compiled by Gilbert Muhanguzi for the news.